Hey everybody, welcome back to our channel. So it's Monday, October 23rd, and we're putting on our crock pot meal. It's 3:30 in the afternoon, so we're starting a little bit later, but I'm trying to be mindful of my cook time. The kids and I have to go over to Taekwondo because Saturday they have a tournament, and so we're trying to get in as much practice as we can, and we're going to be there probably until about 7:30, so that gives us about 4 hours. I'm gonna put this on low because I'm really mainly doing veggies, and I think 4 hours is gonna be plenty enough time. So we're making crock pot spaghetti squash, that is. So I'm gonna start off my crock pot. I sprayed the bottom of my pan. I must invest in some crock pot liners. It just has to happen for my life. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in some veggies. So I'm doing small onion. And I'm just chopping it up in my chopper. To this, I'm going to add in my mushrooms. To that, I'm going to add in some frozen turkey sausage. All right, I've got all my ingredients so far in my pot. I've got onions, peppers, celery, mushrooms, and my sausage that I just actually put through the chopper as well. They are par frozen. And I wanted them in smaller pieces. So now the next thing I'm going to do is just give it a light seasoning. This is a little bit of pink Himalayan sea salt. There's a lot of veg in there, so make sure you season to your tasting. This is a little bit of ground black pepper. I'm going to do a little bit of minced onions, although I do have a fresh whole onion in there. To that, I'm going to add in some garlic. I mean, that was onion powder, and then this is garlic powder. Do a little bit of the table blend that I get from Aldi. It's kind of the generic Mrs. Dash. Last but not least, a little bit of the fifth season Italian seasoning. Now, I'm gonna put my squash in. So what I did was cut it in half. Trying to cut a squash is very challenging. So my recommendation is to poke holes in your outer shell and microwave it for 5 minutes, which is what I did. So I pulled all the pulp out, and so now what I'm going to do is just take my fork. It's not done, but it's starting to be a little bit done. So I'm just going to take my fork and shred my spaghetti into my crock pot. You just want to get all that flesh out. Pull out as much of that flesh as you can. So all you have left is really the shell. And remember, it's not done. If you wanted to do your veggies ahead of time and then just did this as a last step, you could. But we're going to do it now. And then we're just going to take our shell into the trash. And this is the other side. And it's very firm. You can start seeing that it's starting to pull away from the sides. But we only par microwaved it just so we could scoop it out. Remember, we are doing a little bit more of the low carb, so it made sense if we wanted to still have spaghetti to be able to have it, but just use the spaghetti squash instead. And try to scoop as much of that flesh out as you possibly can. And so that's what you have. And then underneath there, you have all your veg. Okay, now that I got my squash in, and remember underneath there, I have all of my veg. So I'll show you, there's all my veg under there. My onions, my peppers, my mushrooms, my celery. I did not put any carrots in here. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to put in my Barilla garlic Alfredo sauce. And the reason I picked this one, I was looking for spaghetti sauces that were low in carbs. So this per serving has 4 grams of carbs, 1 gram of protein. So that would be 3 net grams of carbs per serving. This was the lowest one I could find. The red sauces were really high in carbs. So I'm gonna give this a try. And again, we are new to the low carb lifestyle. We're trying this as well as still counting smart points. So this may not be the right brand, but it, based on the knowledge that I had when I was at the grocery store and the coupons that I had, this is what I chose to get for this particular, and what I'm using for this particular meal. So I do want to try to get as much of that out as I possibly can. And I was going to put 2 in there, but I think I'm just going to put 1. All right. I'm going to give that just a little bit of a quick stir. I do have this on low. I'm going to give it just another 1/4 cup of the cream. There we go. Just to make sure there's enough liquid in the bottom of that. So true confession, this is my first time doing this meal in the crock pot. We'll see how it turns out. We'll bring you back when we're done. Hey everybody, welcome back. So we're done with our crock pot meal. And I did a crock pot spaghetti squash. To this, I added in onions, peppers, mushrooms, turkey sausage, 1 whole spaghetti squash, about a medium squash. You probably could use a large for the sauce. 1 jar of the Barilla Alfredo sauce and about 1/2 cup of fat-free, half and half. So looking back on this, I would probably reduce the 1/2 to 1/4 cup because it is a little bit more juicy than probably I would like it to be, or maybe a larger squash, that might be it. So here's, at the very last, we threw in a handful of broccoli. You can also throw in some spinach,
I'm going to do a quarter cup of mozzarella cheese. And I'm going to do a quarter cup of the fat-free cheddar cheese. And then I'm just going to dish this up. While this finished cooking, we actually did some, look at this, y'all. This is my first attempt at keto pancakes. Keto pancakes. I'll let you know what we think. I may even do a little video on this. But we also did some make ahead egg muffins and sausage for the kids for their breakfasts. So I'm going to take this spaghetti scoop and I'm going to scoop out a scoop of the spaghetti squash. That's probably about a cup's worth. Might be a little bit less, but I'm going to say for the purpose of this video, about a cup's worth. And then Jackson might like some of the Alfredo sauce. But there's yellow peppers, red peppers, green peppers, onions, mushrooms, turkey sausage, spaghetti squash, and cheese. And we're gonna have Jack step in and let us know what he thinks about the spaghetti squash. It's hot, bud. You have the bud. Warm, cheesy, you can taste the sausage. We cut up some turkey sausage and put it in here, and it's very delicious. You can sub in ground turkey meat. If you like turkey meat, you can take the meat totally out. If you're not a meat person, you could actually put any type of veggie that you love within here, and it would be really good. You could also do a red sauce, because we were looking to do a little bit low carb. I chose the Alfredo sauce because it had less carbs. And I think earlier I said it was only 3 net carbs. I think that I got that wrong. Let me see. It's 4 net carbs, because there's 4 total carbs and 0 fiber. You subtract the fiber, not the protein. My apologies. As I'm learning this, I'm just walking through it. So 4 carbs per serving of the Alfredo sauce. And there you have it. The taste tester has given you his honest opinion. If you like this video, be sure and give us a thumbs up. If you're enjoying Crock-Tober, be sure to give us a thumbs up. If you're new around here, hit the red subscribe button. We'd love to keep you as a part of our YouTube community. And also hit the bell, that way you never miss an upload from us. Thank you so much for stopping by our kitchen, and we'll see you tomorrow for Crock-Tober Day 24. Bye.